We have more on Professor Jonathan Gruber. Turns out he visited the White House nearly 24 times. As recently as this summer, he paid a visit. Press Secretary Josh Earnest says he isn't sure if Gruber is done working for the government. Republican Congressman from Tennessee, Diane Black, is with us. Congressman, welcome to the program. Now, I got to tell you, there is a level of frustration here when we look at this string of scandals with nothing happening. Look at the IRS, 2 years old, the scandal. We're going nowhere with that thing. And I have a suspicion that the Gruber tapes will gradually disappear and be forgotten about. What are you going to do about this?
Well, first of all, Stuart, I want to say kudos to the American people because they have not been in favor of this Obamacare since the beginning. And so as Gruber called them stupid, we see that the American people are smarter than what he thinks. And we are going to be having hearings here on the Hill. And I think not only those hearings should bring up the fact that he thought that the American people were not smart enough to understand what was going on, but there's another piece that's not being talked about that much, and that is the torturous writing that was a part of his plan so that it wasn't the bill wasn't scored properly by the CBO. You know, I think that's unconscionable as well because lawmakers make decisions upon what CBO, the nonpartisan scoring group, gives us. And these are decisions not just being made for today, but for 10 years down the road. And so he's got to be held accountable for what he did. I just think it's very interesting that he's being denied being known by the very people who have met with him and talked about him in several of the clips that now have been exposed.
I wish Congress would take a look at some of the consultants being paid millions of dollars to mess us all up with climate change, because I'm sure they're beavering away within the EPA. I'd love you to take a look at that. But I know that you are a registered nurse. I think you've been a nurse for 40 years. You were formerly an emergency room nurse. I remember that from your bio. And now we have Marilyn Tavener. She's been described as having a temper tantrum, demanding official. She's hell-bent on launching healthcare.gov. She was in charge of the launch, or part of it at least, despite warnings that it wasn't ready. Here's a quote from her second in command. Just so you know, Tavener decided in January we were going no matter what. Hence the really cruel and uncaring march that has occurred since January when she threatened me with a demotion or forced retirement if I didn't take this on. This is all about Obamacare, the disastrous launch and the disastrous process that we're going through now. You can't get it repealed though, can you?
Well, that will be up to the new Congress. I believe when we get new members, we're going to see this discussion that is going to continue to go on, and we continue to find out more and more. We know that Kathleen Sebelius, then when she was the Secretary of HHS, that she was demanding that this would be started, even though it wasn't ready. I have been talking about security breaches in this program now for, I know, at least the last 2 years, because it was not ready. We knew that by several reports. The GAO reported that, and now to hear that Marilyn Tavender was just a part of that conversation where you would demand and almost threaten people with their jobs, their retirement, their demotions. It is so disturbing, and it's no wonder the American people don't have confidence in Congress or the administration.
I can just sense from our viewers a level of frustration which is just rising and rising and rising. Nothing ever changes, whether it's crazy government spending, shrimp on a treadmill. It happens year after year. The IRS scandal, Obama care is a mess. There's a frustration level here, and I just want to make you aware of that.
Oh, I'm aware of it, Stuart. I hear it from my constituents all the time. And to be really honest with you, I am frustrated. I am frustrated when you cannot even get the Senate to discuss the bills that are sent to them and debate them. I'm not even saying pass them, but at least bring them up as our founding fathers meant it to be, where there would be discussion between these two chambers. And then send something to the president. He hasn't had any of these bills. We've got 380 bills that are sitting there waiting for Harry Reid to even allow them to be discussed. I am sure hopeful that in this next Congress, we're going to see something different. So
pound that table, Congressman. Pound that table. We love to see you do it. Diane Black, everyone, thank you so much for joining us. We do appreciate
it. Thank you, Stuart.
Thank you. Time's